Please rise for the presentation of colors by the United States Army Color Guard from the St. Peter's Recruiting Station and the playing of our national anthem by the Fort Zumwalt South High School Combined Wind Ensemble and Symphonic Band under the direction of Mr. Paul Allmeyer. Please remain standing and join in a moment of remembrance for America's fallen by placing your hand over your heart as a bell rings in their honor. On Memorial Day, at 3 o'clock that afternoon, wherever you are, please pause to unite with fellow Americans in the national moment of remembrance established by the United States Congress. You may be seated. Our graduates were escorted this afternoon by Ms. Serena Moore, Student Council President for 2022-23, and Mr. Grayson Chapman, Senior Class President for 2022-23. Senior choir members, will you begin to make your way to the risers now? The gentleman leading our vocal music program at South High School once stood where our graduates are, but that was 26 years ago, I believe. This afternoon, seniors from our South High School Choral Program, under the direction of Mr. Jason Martin, will bring us One Moment in Time, followed by our alma mater, led by our assistant choir director, Mrs. Megan England.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Martin. Mrs. England, very well done. Choir seniors, thank you. One more round of applause for them. Members of the class of 2022, Dr. DeBray, members of our Board of Education, faculty, family, and friends, welcome to the commencement exercises for the class of 2022 for Fort Zumwalt South High School. Graduates, as part of the South High family, today you join a prestigious group. You've wrapped up 4 years of the Bulldog experience, and you leave here later this afternoon as graduates of South High School, ready to step in and tackle new and exciting challenges. It's like being young, growing old, and having arrived all on the same day. Remember that. We'll talk about that in a little bit. You've made an impact on South High School history, and you've set the stage for others who will follow in your footsteps for years to come. With us this afternoon are several distinguished guests. As they stand, would you please help me in recognizing, joining us on stage, our district superintendent, Dr. Bernie DeBray. Our deputy superintendent, Dr. Paul Myers. Representing Fort Zumwalt School District's Board of Education, our board president, Mrs. Erica Powers. Mr. Craig Moore. And Dr. Jeff Marion. Many of our teachers and staff members are helping this afternoon with the ceremony behind the scenes with caps and gowns and escorting each row of students. South High teachers and staff members, would you please stand? Thank you. Administrators at South High School and our support staff members make much of this ceremony possible. Please join me in recognizing our activities director, Mr. Ryan Rapp. Our ninth grade assistant principal, Dr. Angie Hong. Our 11th grade assistant principal, Mr. Joe Searles. And you love her, our 12th grade assistant principal, the lady that takes care of you guys, Dr. Deesa Garbarini. Four ladies have worked diligently to finalize the details behind this afternoon's ceremony. First of all, and foremost, our 12th grade secretary, Ms. Christina Berth. Mrs. Berth. Our 10th grade secretary, Mrs. Marnie Hager. Our 11th grade secretary, Ms. Sue Behrman. And keeping me in line, our building secretary, Mrs. Elaine Vollmer. Additionally, please join me in recognizing another guest with us this afternoon, the Ward 1 Alderman from the City of St. Peter's and a Zumwalt South Bulldog through and through, Mr. Rocky Reitmeier. Rocky. We also have with us this afternoon four individuals who mark today as a milestone in their lives as they are retiring from South High School and the Fort Zumwalt School District. As they stand, please join me in recognizing, you saw her as you came in this afternoon, paraprofessional, Ms. Debbie Breeden. Debbie. One of the most gracious gentlemen you'll ever run into, industrial technology teacher, Mr. David Brown. A bundle of laughs and a hoot in the classroom, English language arts teacher, Ms. Jan Byrne. And you love her, your senior class sponsor, one of them, business education teacher, Mrs. Ann Clemmie. Mrs. Clemmie. These folks have been instrumental in the success of our students, and I echo our parents, teachers, and students in thanking them for their dedication and hard work. The class of 2022 has made many contributions to South High School. Whether they're academic, athletic, or service-oriented in nature, your accomplishments have defined you as a group and solidified your place in the history of South High School. So what are some of those accomplishments? Let's talk academically for a second. Of the 324 graduates in this class, 104 of you have a 24 or higher on the ACT. 21 of you scored 31 or better to qualify for Missouri's Bright Flight Scholarship. 3 of you are National Merit Finalists. 135 of you have earned a grade point average of 3.0 or better over 4 years. 72 of you garnered a cumulative grade point average at or above 4.0. 2 of you are named this year as part of Missouri's top 100 academic senior scholars in the state of Missouri. You've had numerous outstanding performances in virtually every athletic and co-curricular activity available at South High School, including district championships, state playoff appearances, individual and team state championships, a Class 3 boys soccer championship this past fall, and this next weekend, our girls are poised to try it again at the state soccer championships, and ideally, they'll bring home another first place trophy. During your 4 years, your class helped solidify South High School's ranking as consistently being one of the highest performing schools academically in St. Charles County and in our school district, and your leadership, along with the outstanding work of your teachers, was incredibly significant as U.S. News and World Report magazine recently, once again, named South High School is one of the best high schools in America, more recognition by this measure than any other school in our school district. Yes, good stuff. It's also my honor to recognize students wearing special medallions and cords. Graduates who have earned membership in the National Honor Society are wearing a gold National Honor Society collar. National Honor Society members, would you please stand? Thank you. Graduates who earn credit in at least 6 credits in weighted courses and have an overall grade point average between 3.8 and 3.99 are designated as cum laude scholars and are wearing bronze medallions. Cum laude scholars, would you please stand? Thank you. Earning credit in at least 6 weighted grade credits and having an overall grade point average between 4.0 and 4.19, those individuals are designated as magna cum laude scholars and are wearing silver medallions. Magna cum laude scholars, would you please stand? Thank you. The following graduates earned credit in at least 6 weighted courses and have a grade point average at 4.2 or higher and are designated as summa cum laude scholars. They're wearing gold medallions. As I read these graduates' names, graduates, would you please stand and remain standing? And I ask your parents to stand and be recognized as well with you. And if you would, please hold your applause until we've announced all of them. Claire Albrecht, daughter of Doug and Jennifer Albrecht. Morgan Anderson, daughter of Kevin and Angie Anderson. Cassidy Avery, daughter of Kenneth and Julie Avery. Jacob Barber, son of Jeff and Jennifer Barber. Elias Barrow, son of Mike and Julie Barrow. Jacob Bider, son of Dan Bider and Carrie Bowling. Connor Berliner, son of Douglas and Laurie Berliner. Kyla Bethel, daughter of Eric and Rebecca Bethel. Megan Boyd, daughter of Christopher and Susan Boyd. Grace Boyer, daughter of Brian and Melissa Boyer. Catherine Britt, daughter of Mark and Andrea Britt. Lacey Burrows, daughter of Steve and Christine Burrows. Ashley Sedino, daughter of Erlen Cedeno and Tanya Mayan. John Costain, son of Patrick and Christy Costain. Caught me there. Sorry, John. Cadence Dempsey, daughter of Tom and Kimberly Dempsey. Karthik Digavali, son of Venkata and Srinaga Digavali. Kirsten DeLacy, daughter of Charles and Cheryl DeLacy. Chloe Donovan, daughter of Jerry and Rebecca Donovan. Cameron Flynn, daughter of David and Heather Flynn. Joseph Friedel, son of Bill and Kristen Friedel. Carson Genovese, son of Michael and Roxanne Genovese. Madeline Hennessy, daughter of James and Christine Hennessy. Gwyneth Hogan, daughter of Matthew and Ashley Hogan. Melissa Hong, daughter of Paul and Sadie Getson. Alexander Hughes, son of Mike and Christy Hughes. Gabriel Kniesel, daughter of Peter and Anna Kniesel. Santino Licamelli, son of Vincent and Gina Licamelli. Gina Leesman, daughter of Steve and Stephanie Leesman. Austin Mahoney, son of Michael and Lori Mahoney. Anshuman Mishra, son of Risha and Ranjita Mishra. Akhil Mogaluthu, son of Ramesh and Geetha Mogaluthu. Jordan Moore, daughter of Darren and Colleen Moore. Twisha Nadella, daughter of Chandrashekhar and Kavitha Nadella. Amanda Olivas, daughter of George and Wendy Olivas. Ella Orlando, daughter of John and Tricia Orlando. Shaylin Phelps, daughter of Richard and Jennifer Phelps. Samantha Pika, daughter of Craig and Tracy Pika. Tyson Pilla, son of Charlie and Robin Pilla. Kaylin Rabel, son of Richard and Sharon Rabel. Ananda Rich, daughter of Corey and Amanda Best and Jeremy and Brittany Rich. Matthew Robison, son of Michael and Jayla Robison. Hannah Schaffner, daughter of Thomas and Jill Schaffner. Sophie Stevens, daughter of Marcus and Thalia Stevens. Nicholas Stovall, son of Brian and Jan Stovall. Sydney Truscott, daughter of Scott and Nicole Truscott. Sophia Ung, daughter of Patrick Ung and Leah Howe. Nicole Voss, daughter of Brian and Tricia Voss. Emily Watson, daughter of Troy and Nicole Watson. Austin Williams, son of Brian and Della Williams. Allison Wilson, daughter of Russ and Angie Wilson. Leo Wright, son of Todd Wright and Don Pfeffer Wright. Please join me in congratulating these outstanding students. Thank you. With some opening remarks as we continue this afternoon's ceremony, please join me in welcoming our district superintendent to the stage, Dr. Bernie DeBray.
Thank you, Kevin. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you all for being here and joining in this ceremony for our 324 seniors who will be graduating in the next hour or so. I'd like to welcome you on behalf of the Board of Education to this 33rd graduation ceremony at South High School. I've been at all 33, and by my count, that means about 12,000 South High graduates I've seen walk across the stage at the culmination of their 13-year journey in the Fort Zumwalt School District. It never gets old, and I look forward to today's ceremony as well. I'll try to keep my comments short, but there are just a few things I think I need to say. First of all, I want to congratulate our seniors for getting to this milestone in their life. It is a milestone. You only have one high school graduation. You met all the requirements of the Board of Education, the state of Missouri. Nobody is seated among you that hasn't met those requirements, so it is a significant accomplishment, and you deserve congratulations reaching that point. How about a nice hand for our seniors? I know there'll be a lot of opportunities for applause, so we'll move along. I also want to thank our staff, for those staff members that are here today, for another good teaching year. The past 2 years, you've taught through a pandemic. We thought this year it wouldn't be as difficult as the previous year, but it was even more difficult. So you've persevered, you've hung in there, and look at the results. You've brought these seniors and our other students through the year, and it was a very good one. So I want to thank you all. I want to thank Kevin Keltner and the leadership team for guiding you all through these 2 years. It's been difficult, but rewarding, and that we made it through it. How about a nice hand of applause for the faculty and the administration? In 1987, our school district started planning all-night graduation parties to go along with our graduation exercises. Parents of the school really take the lead in the planning, because once you've graduated, you're technically not our students any longer. And so over the years, parents have taken that lead and planned really exciting opportunities for our students. So they stay together later this evening, through the night. The whole intent, of course, is to keep them safe and avoid any tragedies that might be associated with these exciting times. And since 1987, in all of our high schools, all five of them, there hasn't been anything like that. So we know that the efforts of our parents have really paid off. And I think it's worth me calling out their names, have you stand and be recognized by our audience. These are the parents that took the lead in planning tonight's all-night graduation exercise. So, Mel and Alana Askins, please stand. Jeff and Jana Balkenbush, please stand, be recognized. Brian and Melissa Boyer, please stand. Michelle Carroll, please stand. William and Mary Dillon, please stand to be recognized. Kara Reynolds, please stand. Angie Sowell, please stand. Lisa Shimonia, please stand. And Brian and Jan Stovall, please stand to be recognized. Thank you, guys. We know your efforts have paid off. Kevin Keltner began ceremonies talking to you a little bit about what Memorial Day is all about. Some people like to have our graduation exercises on Memorial Day weekend, and some don't. Sometimes that interferes with plans on a national holiday. I'd like it to be on Memorial Day weekend, because you students know that every Veterans Day, we have special exercises or special plans to recognize our veterans. And this is a way of trying to let them know how much we revere them for what they've done. Many veterans have paid the ultimate price with their lives for the freedoms that we have today. Memorial Day is a 160-year-old celebration. Started just after the Civil War with some Civil War widows that decorated the graves of some 600,000 soldiers that were killed on both sides in our Civil War. It stayed Decoration Day through to 1971, and then it became Memorial Day, a national holiday. And as Dr. Keltner mentioned, at 3 o'clock on the last Monday in May, we should take time to think about what our veterans have meant to us and have done for us. And I hope you'll do that, because, you know, as our veterans age, we don't want to indicate to them that we don't remember what they've done for us. So I would think about three o'clock on this Monday, Memorial Day. Now, we have some students here, four students at South High that have decided to join the military, and think it would be appropriate to point them out. So please stand as I call your name. Joining the U.S. Army, Hunter Fox and Logan Rogers. and the U.S. Marines, Curtis Burton and Ben Sawell. Thank you guys. We appreciate you volunteering for our military service and protecting us all. And now, could we have everyone in the audience and on stage who have been a veteran, please stand and be recognized by the audience. Please stand. Thank you so much. I love the opportunity to do that. We will never forget you. Please enjoy the rest of the ceremony.
Thank you, Dr. DeBray. Before I present this year's Citizenship Award and Leadership and Loyalty Award, seniors, let's talk. Young, old, and arrived. You remember I said that a little bit earlier. Three important concepts that I've found to be pretty important for graduation. Let's talk about being young, growing old, and having arrived. It came to me at prom. Now, as you recall, we haven't hosted a prom since you guys were freshmen. And so this year's event was a pretty big deal. It was great to see all of you coming into Old Hickory. Most of you were there. And a wonderful evening got underway. I thought about 4 years of stuff and the excitement in that room, the energy you displayed at prom, that was pretty cool. It was contagious, and I knew I was young. And then I listened to your music. And I knew I was old. Not once did I hear George Strait, did I hear Alabama, and I was even paying the DJ. I mean, that's not a good thing. And then, which is quite the thing to do these days, several of you over the next few hours there began doing the cool thing. Let's take a picture. Let's take a selfie. Lots of selfies, just celebrating an evening. And with one of those selfies, Reagan, I think it was you and a few of your friends, you said, Dr. Keltner, this is so cool. You're going to make the gram. I'll tag you. Parents, if one of these folks ever tells you, you're going to make the gram, I'll tag you, you may have arrived. And folks, if you have no idea what I was talking about, ask one of these guys afterwards, they'll tell you. All that being said, Charles Anderson is a good friend of mine. He's all of these things. He's young, he's old, and he's arrived. He's an Army Ranger. And those guys are tough. They get stuff done. I spoke with him just the other day as he stepped off a tractor after mowing his yard. And by young, Charles is one of the youngest individuals I know. He's sharp. He's always on top of things. He has a drive and energy that you just don't often see. At the same time, he's old. He approaches things with maturity. He takes time to put things in perspective. By having arrived, he knows that the accomplishments he makes are just the starting point for what he's about to do next. You see, as I told you, Charles is an Army Ranger. Charles is a member of the 6th Army Ranger Battalion, where he learned a lot of those things. His most recent tour of duty had him in the Philippine Islands as he helped return that land to the Filipino people in 1945. In World War II. Charles will turn 96 in a few weeks. So what's the takeaway? You're still young, and that's a great thing. Capitalize on that energy and keep that spirit alive. Just don't ever lose that. But as I said, you're also old. At South High School, you were the oldest people we had there. And being old means you've gotten to a point where you understand that along with all of your young energy, you have a certain level of maturity that affords you to make informed decisions based on experience and knowledge. It means you understand the idea of personal responsibility. You're not defined by your parents. You're not defined by the neighborhood you grew up in. you can chart your own course. And having arrived means you can celebrate incredible achievements, just as we're celebrating this afternoon with your graduation, and recognize that that achievement is the foundation and starting point for the next achievement that's ahead of you. So graduates, please, stay young, grow old, and arrive with this perspective, and I'm confident you'll create a life where you make a valuable and meaningful impact for generations to come. As we continue with our ceremony, each year, our faculty votes and selects a graduate to receive the Fort Zumwalt South High School Citizenship Award. This award goes to a student determined by our faculty members who best displays the qualities that we desire to see among all students, including strong academic achievement, outstanding relationships, and a passion for South High School and helping others. Our Citizenship Award recipient for the class of 2022 is an individual who is seen as a never give up, tackle anything kind of person. This year's recipient, on top of being recognized earlier this afternoon as a summa cum laude scholar, has also been involved in three sports, earning all conference and all district honors in each of them. In addition to being academic all-state in basketball, this individual has been a member of our Final Four baseball team in 2021, our state quarterfinal basketball team, and was named Gateway Athletic Conference Central Player of the Year in golf. He earned all-state honors in golf and was named as a St. Louis Post-Dispatch Scholar Athlete in 2022. Whether it's in the classroom or in athletics, this individual never seems to get rattled and works not only to have fun, but to bring out the best in others. A member of PPI in our leadership league, he's headed this fall to Missouri University of Science and Technology in Rolla to study architectural engineering, along with being part of the Miners golf team. An overwhelming choice of our faculty. I ask his parents, Bill and Kristen, would you please stand and join me in congratulating a remarkable young man as he makes his way to the podium as our Citizenship Award recipient, Mr. Joey Friedel. I told our graduates in rehearsal as we were going through things that we would have a set of stairs right here in the middle, and whoever won that award should come up front like there. That's why Joey was looking at me kind of funny saying, how do I get up here? And so, congratulations. Each year our faculty also selects a graduate to receive the Fort Zumwalt South High School Leadership and Loyalty Award. Students nominated for this award must be heavily involved in many aspects of our school, leaving a positive mark on both people and activities at South High School through their leadership. Our Leadership and Loyalty Award recipient for the class of 2022 is all smiles and all business at the same time. A member of our leadership league, empowering young women, and an Essence of PPI Award winner, this individual is a person to which leadership seems to come naturally, whether it be in a school organization or in front of a row of a cheering section at a game. Selected as part of Missouri's Hugh O'Brien Youth Leadership Seminar, this individual is an organizer and planner at heart, and you'll find her at ease even in the most challenging of situations, all the while handling things with both a mature perspective and a smile. This fall, she heads to Truman State University on True Merit and President's Honorary Scholarships, majoring in special education, and we're hoping she'll return home to work with us. I ask her parents, Ryan and Maria, to stand, and would you please join me in congratulating another overwhelming choice of our faculty as she makes her way to the platform, the president of the class of 2022 and this year's Leadership and Loyalty Award recipient, Ms. Libby Bishop. Joey and Libby, we couldn't be more proud of you. Congratulations once again on those two honors. Good job. Our faculty address this afternoon will be brought to us by Mr. Jason Martin. Aside from his duties at South High School as our director of vocal music, Mr. Martin is an active presenter, adjudicator, and clinician for Missouri's choral community. He serves as the executive director of the Choral Society of St. Charles County, community choir repertoire and resources chair for the Missouri Choral Directors Association, and is a secondary performing arts curriculum coordinator for the Ford Zumwalt School District. He recently completed a term as the Choral Vice President for the Missouri Music Educators Association. Other past appointments include positions with the Lindbergh School District, Church of the Shepherd United Methodist, and Ambassadors of Harmony. Mr. Martin was the recipient of the Missouri Choral Directors Association's Prelude Award in 2006. In 2010, he was named South High School's Teacher of the Year, and twice he's been named as Director of the Year and once the Music Educator of the Year for the St. Louis Music Metro District. The highlight of his career was the 2019-20 Chamber Choir selection to perform at the Missouri Music Educators Association State Convention. When he's not directing music, he loves supporting the growth of his family and forever chasing his beautiful and forgiving wife's honeydew list. Selected by our senior class, he's one of our South High School graduates, and you got to see him just a moment ago. Please join me in welcoming our faculty speaker this afternoon, Mr. Jason Martin.
Good afternoon, seniors, Dr. Keltner, Dr. Dubray, members of the Board of Education, administrators, faculty, friends, family, staff. When word spread that I'd be standing here speaking with you, I began hearing it was assumed I'd be singing as part of this speech. It's quite presumptuous. I'm a little insulted. I'm not paid by the taxpayers in this room to sing. I'm paid to make you sing. Seniors, I'll be honest, I'm a little bit nervous about how this next part of my speech is going to go, but if it works, the science says it will be more memorable. If it doesn't work, the next several minutes are going to be really awkward, which is also memorable, by the way, but I know you wouldn't want to see me struggle. So to lessen our collective anxiety of not just you singing, I'm actually going to help ask everyone to help us sing. There's supposed to be a reaction there. Okay, here we go. So, but before you get all freaked out, I'm going to give you my first bit of advice, and that was something a senior told me years ago. The senior said, the rule of five. I said, what's the rule of five? And they said, will it matter in 5 minutes, 5 hours, 5 days, 5 weeks, 5 months, et cetera, et cetera. And so no matter how well you sing for me just right now, just remember that at your 5 or 10 year reunion, no one's going to remember how bad you sounded, okay? So, and this goes for everybody. We're going to do this together. So, for the next 10 seconds, this goes for everyone, I'm going to allow you to apologize to the person ahead of time who's sitting next to you or directly in front or behind you, and you're going to encourage them by saying things like, you're going to sound great, or simply saying sorry. You have 10 seconds. Begin. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. It's a song that most of you know. Will you please join me when your ear catches it? You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away. Hey, that went really well. Good job. Congratulate each other, will you? So when I was 2 years old, some of you might remember there was a commercial. There was a French's mustard commercial, and a little kid sang that. And as my mom was learning to speak English, she learned that song, and she sang it to me when I was a little kid. And it was one of the first songs I ever remember hearing. And as I look at you and your families here today, I can't help but think of how you've shaped each other's lives. What songs you sang together, maybe what traditions you shared. I think about how my relationship with my parents shaped me as an 18-year-old and how much that differed as an adult. So much has happened in my family over those 40-plus years since she first sang that to me. See, when she sang it to me at the time, I didn't know that we were poor. poor enough that she only was able to keep two outfits for herself. She'd have to wear one while washing the other every day. To keep us fed, she sometimes had to borrow change from our piggy banks while we were sleeping, only to refund it years later or when she could, when our family got back on their feet. We didn't have much, but we never went without because of her. And that was in stark contrast to what she grew up with. See, my mom, her mom left home when she was just 5 years old. Her parents had a divorce, and it was a very dysfunctional family. And since her dad worked long hours and dealing with his own alcohol addiction, my mom was left in the care of her older sister. Well, that older sister eventually became her abuser. She first scratched my mom, and then slapped my mom, and then punched my mom. And eventually that turned to beatings with a pipe, so much so that my mom would sometimes have seizures. To show that my mom was well-fed so she could show their father, she would overfeed my mom. She'd force-feed her until she couldn't hold the food down anymore. When she had heard from her brothers that her mom was just a few towns away, she ran away. Just the clothes on her back, no money in her pocket, no food, no water. It was 3 days later that she was found, huddled up in a phone booth. She said her stomach hurt because she hadn't eaten. Her eyes had closed shut because of the mucus that was holding them. And they had just assumed that she had died. She was only 7 years old at the time. Throughout her school years, neglect became another companion on her journey. She never had lunch money or school supplies. She says she remembers trying to look for a pencil on the hallway floor or even in her classroom, even borrowing paper from neighbors because she just didn't have any. She came to school unbathed in dirty clothes, and when her toes hurt too badly because her shoes were too small, she'd have to bend the heel down to keep wearing them. The abuse continued until she could find a place of her own. She moved out when she was 18, and one of the three jobs that she worked so she could move out was at a restaurant near the Air Force Base where my father worked. She was his waitress. They got married, they moved to the United States, had three kids, me being the third. Now, my relationship with my parents wasn't so perfect growing up. I often didn't agree with their policies. I maybe didn't appreciate what she'd gone through to have us. The relationship between my dad and I consisted of him doing a lot of yelling and punishing to keep order in the house. He didn't show up to many games and concerts and never seemed to care about how I was doing. I remember wondering if I would ever make him proud. It was much easier to avoid him and keep him uninvolved in my life than to deal with him. This was such a stark contrast to my mom. And I remember asking her one time, I was in college, I was feeling good about myself, and I said, "Mom, what did you want to be when you grew up? What was your dream?" She was a waitress for her adult life. And she said, "Jason, I just dreamed about having a family." Even though I perhaps expected perfection from my parents, I definitely was not a perfect child. I did a lot of things that may have gotten me suspended from school or even arrested. I spent time in that Saturday detention room. Like maybe some of you, I got into fights, did some shoplifting, smoked, snuck out of the house, etc. And as payback for my behavior, I now have two teenagers of my own. It's a lot of fun, folks, right? So, I carry a lot of feelings about the manner in which I was raised. It was very very hot and cold, a lot of variety in the way I was brought up. My mother responded to her own childhood with forgiveness and empathy. And at one point, her father even came to her begging on his knees, literally, for forgiveness for the neglect that she dealt with and how disjointed he was from the family. It's one of the most important qualities that I can carry forward. What's been more difficult is to navigate what I learned from my dad. The resentment I felt toward him was very taxing on my energy, and I'm fortunate that as adults, we're able to reconcile our relationship, a lot of it done through playing guitar and singing songs together. This didn't happen overnight, though. It took many years of effort on both of our parts to unpack. I was able to thank him for the roof he put over my head and the hard lessons he taught me along the way. He was finally able to convey how proud he was of me and the family I had built, despite his shortcomings as a father. These lessons hold an incredible amount of power in how I live my life as a parent, a spouse, and a teacher, especially since losing him this past year. I recently heard that of all the time you'll spend with your parents, 97% of that will have passed by the time you reach your 18th birthday. As both a father and a son, I thought this terrifying. There's little time to linger on the past, So I work hard to make the best decision I can for my family, but I often make mistakes. I think that even the teachers here in this room wish we could have moments back, but no one is afforded that opportunity. So, what are you going to do with the 3%? Will you only remember the worst fights and screaming matches? Will you appreciate the path that brought you to this moment today? Will you look at your families with grace for their imperfections? Will you store resentment, or will you grow from it? Will you show others the love you've received? It's in your court. I challenge you to continually reflect and then grow into yourselves. It's a bright future. Even when you're your parents and grandparents' age, it's hard to know how to start. So something as simple as a song can get things rolling, just like the one my mom sang to me, and now I sing to my own family. You are my sunshine, the thing that brings light to my life when it's otherwise dark. You bring me happiness and joy when things are dreary and I'm feeling down. You'll never fully know or understand the magnitude of my love. Please don't ever take my sunshine away from me. I'd like you to think about someone, this goes for everybody, quite possibly someone in this room, who you love with the same depth that our song conveys, someone who is your sunshine. And in closing, I invite you all to sing one more time. Will you please join me? You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away. Congratulations, class of 2022.
Thank you, Mr. Martin. Our Board of Education will assist me as we proceed with this afternoon's commencement exercises. Mrs. Powers, on behalf of the faculty and administration of Fort Zumwalt South High School, I hereby attest that these individuals have met the graduation requirements of the Fort Zumwalt School District as set forth by the Fort Zumwalt School District's Board of Education and the Missouri Department of Elementary and Secondary Education. It's an honor for me, as principal of South High School, to present to you the class of 2022. Please refrain from yelling or applauding during the awarding of diplomas so that the names of all of our graduates can be heard. The calling of our names will be done this afternoon by Mr. Andy Delahanty, Science Department Chair at South High School, and Mr. Michael Schneider, Social Studies Department Chair at South High School. Members of the class of 2022, please prepare to receive your diplomas.
Lily Grace Abbott. Mark Richard Akins. Claire Elizabeth Albrecht, summa cum laude. Danilo Gomez Alvarenga. Veronica Ann Amadon. Catherine Grace Anderson. Erica Nicole Anderson, cum laude. Matthew Robert Anderson. Morgan Reve Anderson, summa cum laude. Ava Marie Anzalone. Romulo de Guzman Aquino III. Reese Cameron Askins. Abigail Kara Atherton, cum laude. Ashton Connor Atkins. Haley Augusta. Haley Ray Augustine. Hannah Augustine. Cassidy Lynn Avery, summa cum laude. Kara Nicole Bukowski. Evan Michael Balkenbush. Lisa Bond. Jacob Tyler Barber, summa cum laude. Aubrey Malie Barnfeld. Elias Lucas Barrow, summa cum laude. Alina Michelle Beasley, cum laude. Jacob Andrew Bider, summa cum laude. Connor Douglas Berliner, summa cum laude. Kyla Kennedy Bethel, summa cum laude. Libby Marie Bishop, cum laude. Peyton James Blair. Luca James Bettler. Colton Ray Boschert. Haley Elizabeth Bouchard. Megan Brianne Boyd, summa cum laude. Grace Mackenzie Boyer, summa cum laude. Sarah Elizabeth Bozeman. Catherine Elizabeth Britt, summa cum laude. Brooke Jane Broderick. Nolan Reed Brown. Carson Charles Bubb. Nia Simone Burnett. Andrew Jake Burrows. Lacey Elizabeth Burrows, summa cum laude. Curtis Lilton Burton. Delaney Grace Bushman. Najee Alexis Butler. Cora Bell Calkins. Evelyn Victoria Canada. Evan Robert Carroll. Paige Aline Carter. Rory Grace Cartwright. Owen Walstead Casson. Lillian Kareen Castro. Ian Joseph Kawine. Ashley Dominic Sedano Maljean, summa cum laude. Aiden Michael Clark. Trayson Shea Cole. Delaney Mays Collins, magna cum laude. Lillian Grace Copeland. Chloe Aaron Cornelius. Barrett Paul Cornell. John Patrick Costain, summa cum laude. William Edward Crooker IV. Jaden Zane Crumley, magna cum laude. Shaylin Elizabeth Cunningham. Zoe Lee Curtis. Mallory Marie Daniel, magna cum laude. Colin Patrick Dethridge. Merrick Sharon Delahanty, magna cum laude. Cadence Marie Dempsey, summa cum laude. Abigail Marie Dexter. Elizabeth Nicole Dickinson. Noah Evan Dienst. Karthik Shrisai Digavali, summa cum laude. Luke William Dillon. Zoe Grace Dodson. Kirsten Elizabeth DeLacy, summa cum laude. Precious Miracle Draper. Braden Joseph Dressner. Chloe Marie Donovan, summa cum laude. Jackson George Dunn. Uvia Michelle Duran, cum laude. Carter Thomas Duvenick. Alexander Charles Eaton. Joy Adora Ichazu. Ethan James Eddings. Aaron Marie Elkins. Alex Jordan Ellis. Ezra William Erickson, cum laude. Julia Ruth Evans. Keegan James Everett. Hayden Matthew Ferries. Trenton Darius Fullerton Fetter. Jacob Alexander Flesh. Cameron Marie Flynn, summa cum laude. Hunter Seth Fox. Joseph Clements Friedel, summa cum laude. Nathan Cullen Friend. Diane Fuentes Torres. Jada Abiola Gafari. Sawyer Eugene Gainey. Mia Rose Galati. Cadence Christine Gaylor. Kimberly Garcia, cum laude. Ramiri Kian Gardner. Aiden Michael Gelwicks. Carson Michael Genovese, summa cum laude. Haley Elizabeth Gerard. Carson Michael Gibbs. Devin Patrick Glockner, cum laude. Maxton Robert Gonzalez. Lillian Tabitha Goodman. Olivia Jean Goodman, cum laude. Jade Alexis Graham. Tommy Robert Graham. Fiona Lorraine Grau. Krista Sky Gray. Micah David Gray. Imani Taylor Green. Jonathan Dylan Griggs. Abigail Rose Packer, cum laude. Ethan Daniel Glenn Hafferkamp. Lily Grace Hare, cum laude. Brody Cole Hale. Thomas Carl Hamilton. Benjamin Thomas Hanna. Sophia Kathleen Hanna, magna cum laude. Aiden Allen Hantak. Emma Elise Harding. Jose Nicholas Cruz Harrow. Ryan Scott Harviton. Catherine Louise Heald. Kylie Renee Henderson, magna cum laude. Michael Ryan Hinkey. Madeline Christine Hennessy, summa cum laude. Aiden Scott Hester. Jaden Gregory Higgins. Ava Nicole Hill. Malachi Jacob Hill. Gwyneth Elizabeth Hogan, summa cum laude. Caitlin Michelle Holloway. Melissa Hong, summa cum laude. Morgan Elizabeth Harrell. Abigail Elizabeth Houlihan. Brandon Michael Houston. Cameron Kalia Hubbard. Alexander Michael Hughes, summa cum laude. Haley Nicole Hunsinger. Ethan Thomas Hutchison. Tajay Maurice Houston. Kalina Nicole Ingram. Delaney Elizabeth Jackson. Alyssa Brooke James. Jack Charles Jelinek, magna cum laude. Mariah Jones. Joshua David Jordan. Brandon Tien Kaiser.
Yvonne Kabeti Katambwa. Joseph David Kaufman. Aaron Dean Kaiser, magna cum laude. Seth Jacob Keenan, cum laude. Nicholas Milano Keen. Reagan Michelle King. Gabriel Nicholas Kniesel, summa cum laude. Emily Grace Noble. Nathan George Kanikara. Elena Grace LaFleur. Kennedy Pauline Lakey. Melody Renee Land. Olivia May Lewis. Santino Charles Licamelli, summa cum laude. Jenna Renee Leisman, summa cum laude. Hannah Elizabeth Linderman. Caitlin Beatrice Lockhart. Ryan Joseph Luce. Emma Elizabeth Lott. Jamie Deanne Lawton. Timothy Devin Lowe. Samantha Taylor Lovett. Madison Elaine Luminello. Jaden Ephraim Liu. Austin Tyler Mahoney, summa cum laude. Rory Patrick Mannion. Chase Daniel Markham. Luke Scott Markovich. Hannah Rose Marin. Lucille Francis Martin. Sydney Emma Claire Mathis. Gavin William Mayer. Dennis Michael McGrain III, magna cum laude. Nicole Ann McIntosh. Tyler James McKay, magna cum laude. Michael David McKinney. Eli Bradley McMahon. Quintasia Eugenia Merriweather. Logan James Meyer. Britton Daniel Miner, cum laude. Anshuman Mishra, summa cum laude. Jacqueline Isabel Mitchison. Akil Krishna Mogulothu, summa cum laude. Brandon Verdell Moore. Emily Eileen Moore, cum laude. Grace Catherine Moore. Jordan Page Moore, summa cum laude. Isaac Michael Mormon. Lauren Linda Mort. Claire Jean Mullen. Reagan Alyssa Murray, magna cum laude. Cody Michael Myers. Rebecca Nicole Myers. Twisha Megan Nadella, summa cum laude. Dylan Patrick Neese. Dylan Thomas Nicholson. Tyler J. Nuspel. Brady William O'Brien. Dominic Michael Obremski. Amanda Noel Olivas, summa cum laude. Ella Orlando, summa cum laude. Ellie Nicole Osterholt, magna cum laude. Isabel K. Otto. Brendan Patrick Owens. Jordan Lynn Owens. Andrew James Palmer, cum laude. Aliana Angela Lozada Paradiang. Alexander Joseph Paul. Jacob Riley Peters. Luke Joseph Pfaff. James Robert Pfeiffer. Davian Uy Pham. Shaylin Chase Phelps, summa cum laude. Samantha Grace Picka, summa cum laude. Tyson Walker Pilla, summa cum laude. Samantha Elizabeth Pleasant, cum laude. Daniel Eugene Pauline. Jacoby Kiambre Powell. Michael Ryan Prater. Delson Edward Pachalski. Emma Grace Piles, cum laude. Eric Taylor Reagan, cum laude. Kaylin Thomas Rabel, summa cum laude. Kevin Daniel Rafe. Evelyn Vidiana Ramos. Alonzo Reese. Donovan Lee Reynolds, magna cum laude. Landry Lynn Reynolds, magna cum laude. Damaris Denise Riano. Ananda Star Rish, summa cum laude. Isaac Andrew Rissi, cum laude. Kyle James Roberts. Matthew Michael Robinson, summa cum laude. Elaine Grace Rogers. Logan Andrew Rogers. Bradley David Rosa. Jacob Michael Roth. Noor Singh Sandhu, magna cum laude. Alyssa Faith Sarver, cum laude. Benjamin Nicholas Saywall. Dalen John Shadler. Hannah Irene Schaffner, summa cum laude. Dakota Grace Schluter. Kaplan Patrick Schneider. Peyton Christine Schwartz. Stephen Noble Scoville, magna cum laude. Kelly Elizabeth Seeley. James Evan Seifert. Julia Elizabeth Shelton. Noah Ryan Shook. Alexis Lillian Shirtleff. Ashlyn Ty Smith, magna cum laude. Clayton Matthew Smith. Caleb Emmerich Samoji. Amy Ann Spezia. Sophie Esselina Stevens, summa cum laude. Sorry. Kaylin Elizabeth Stiff, cum laude. Jasmine Marie Stovall, cum laude. Nicholas Brian Stovall, summa cum laude. Kylie Ann Stewart. Blake Wayne Sullivan. Colin Patrick Sullivan. Logan Andrew Certin. Jacob Hamilton Swatek. Victoria Lauren Tankersley. Savannah Lee Tarrant. Margaret Ann Tenholder. Jeffrey Antonio Thornton. Hannah Tiglau. Nicholas Owen Sawyer Tilford. Sydney Ann Truscott, summa cum laude. Colby Matthew Elk. Sophia Ung, summa cum laude. Elena Uristi. Mackenzie Paige Vaught. Raffaello Romeo Bedwa Vinzon. Nicole Josephine Voss, summa cum laude. Alicia Gabrielle Wallace, magna cum laude. Kayla Bryn Walsh. Ryan Lee Walsh. Benjamin Michael Walter, cum laude. Jaden Alexis Waltrip. Keanu Wana. Christopher Andrew Warren. Emily Nicole Watson, summa cum laude. Jaden Sierra Westcott. Jaden Lynn Westhues. Logan Nicholas White. Ashley Catherine Whitman. Nicholas Todd Wickenhauser. Austin Dale Williams, summa cum laude. Shelby James Williams. Allison Louise Wilson, summa cum laude. Colin Wilson, magna cum laude. Peyton Lee Wisdom. Courtney Michelle Womack. Avery David Woods. Allison Michelle Woodworth. Leo Pfeffer Wright, summa cum laude. Noah Stephen Wynn. Zaria Marie Yancey.
324 outstanding young men and women. Congratulations. Now, ladies and gentlemen, a young lady is on the platform now who needs no introduction because you met her a few minutes ago. To close out our ceremony this afternoon, please join me in welcoming once again our senior class president as she steps to the podium, Miss Libby Bishop.
Thank you, Dr. Keltner. I would also like to say thank you to Dr. DeBray, members of the Board of Education, faculty, family, friends, and administrators. I would like to say some final thoughts to you all, but especially to my fellow classmates. What an adventure it has been the past 4 years. Through lots of doubt and unforeseen circumstances that none of us could have imagined, the class of 2022 has persevered and grown into what I think is one of the most influential classes to walk the halls of Fort Smalt South. We have created athletic dominance, as evidenced by winning not just district titles, but also a few state titles, prevailed academically, reestablished traditions, and left our mark on the building. Trying to find a quote to embody this amazing class was definitely a struggle, but I think I hit the mark. Opportunity doesn't knock. It presents itself when you knock down a door. My peers have continuously knocked down many of doors and will proceed to create opportunities for themselves for years to come, I think at least. And now, let's take one final step together as the class of 2022. Please rise. Let me stand up. I'll make it quick, don't worry. And move your tassel from left to right. I would like to introduce to you the Zumwalt South High graduating class of 2022. Congratulations.